Luke is coming in and off.
Of course she is. Okay, hurry up.
Okay.
I'm going to start the vlog.
Have
you quit? Oh, Alice has come out with too many funnies today.
Oh, no, I didn't.
Oh, yes, you did.
Hi and welcome to the vlog. I hope you're all well. We are tired and we need to get to bed. But I'm squeezing in filming this vlog because it is a time limited one. So, hi! Today's vlog is in collaboration with Historic Calendars. No, it's not. Today's vlog is in collaboration with Historic Calendar. There! Got it! There's going to be so many of these. Me saying the wrong thing, that is. Because I am tired and my voice is going because I feel like I'm coming down with something. So if you can hear me by the end of the vlog, we'll be very, very happy. Okay? Let's try and keep it together. And here comes a goblin.
Don't eat your friends.
No, you don't, honey. You're fine. Here comes a goblin. Come and join us on the sofa.
I know that I'm just wearing some shorts because this is the quickest match I could find.
So you didn't see the pyjamas that were lying on top of your bed?
No.
No!
I didn't.
No! You look fine, my darling. We're having a pyjama party. Yes, anyway, Nordic calendars. No, not. Historic calendar. Historic calendar. I really need to get this right. Historic calendar is a project by a bunch of friends, one of whom is a very good friend of mine.
I know him.
Her. Yeah. To create a calendar for 2024 of Norse goddesses. This is what it looks like. And inside,
the pictures.
There are pictures of a number of Norse goddesses. You've got Skade, you've got Freya, you've got Gefjun, you've got Hel, and a whole
Why
bunch of others.
It Swedish?
Why do you think? Well, I can't call her Skade. I'm sorry, I can't say Skade instead of Skade. It doesn't work in my head. These photographs these goddesses, these photographs, they are absolutely amazing. It's my friend who's the photographer and I admire her greatly. And all of, I'm so tired, Caitlin. I can't make it through.
Caitlin, look what I'm wearing.
Oh, very
Shorts.
Cute. Shorts in the winter, yeah. Yes. Should we try this again? In these photographs, depicting these goddesses are a number of models. And they are wearing handmade... Just Alice. It's okay.
Very jumpy.
We are so not going to make it through this.
She said jumpy with my cough, so I don't know why.
Handmade Viking style clothes, handmade accessories, handmade props. There is a Viking age plow. Well, no, it's a modern plow. It's a plow made in modern times. They made it, but it's made of findings from the Viking age. And I mean, they chopped down the tree and made the plow, and it actually works. I mean, this is the level of.
Is that why people cut down trees?
It's why they cut down that tree.
For some reasons.
You get wood.
Which tree? The Christmas tree.
No, the tree they made this plow with, and it actually works. You can actually plow with it. They made the accessories, so Brisingamen. Freya's golden necklace, they created
Freya,
that.
You keep saying, like, the Freya in Swedish.
Of course Freya. I do. Of course, I've just impressed Caitlin, she didn't realise that. Shall I get the picture up for you, Caitlin, and you can go, whoa!
Wow!
She's.
There's Freya, the goddess of love.
Yeah, she's the goddess of love.
So they've used.
Magic and war.
Is she?
She is indeed. Alice has been
well
listening
remembered.
To me. Yes. So everything is handmade. And they wanted to find a really wonderful mixture of traditional Viking age, because these are Viking age and even older goddesses, but also the fantastical and magical. So they're using makeup, they're using photo editing to create that sort of fantastical and magical element. But then, you know, clothes based on off original findings and that kind of stuff to tie it back to that period.
I want to show you the picture of her as the goddess of magic.
There she is, as the goddess of magic, yes.
Oh, wow.
Yes, every month also has a little blurb explaining about the picture and the goddess in the picture for that month. It goes from Monday to Sunday the week. It's in English. Not a single bank holiday is put in there, so it works for wherever you are in the world. This is my favourite picture.
Yes, that's the god that lives in the sea, and she takes
Ran. Ran, the goddess of the sea. Yeah, she takes drowned sailors and drowned fishermen.
Really?
And that is my friend's daughter, Ronja.
Oh, she's gorgeous.
Mm.
Look, that's her as the goddess of death. And not the goddess of
war.
War.
Freya was the first Valkyrie.
What?
Mm. So Freya takes half the warriors slain in battle.
Look, the goddess of death.
Only half go to Valhalla.
The
other half goes
death.
To Freya.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
The god of death.
Caitlin is learning things here.
I am learning things here.
Half of her body looks dead and half of her body looks alive. So she's the god of death.
And her name is Helen.
Hel. That's the goddess of healing.
Well done. Eir, the goddess of healing. Yes.
Then back.
Eir. Air? It's air.
It's
air.
And then the next day of December, the last week of December again.
Yes. Anyway, you can buy this calendar from Historic Calendar's Etsy shop. And I am so pleased to offer you a 20% discount with...
That's the Queen of Gods.
My very special code. Which, of course, I can't remember right now. So, I want you to go and have a look in the description of this video. Or if you can't do that, then go to my Instagram or my Facebook and look at the social media posts I've made about this vlog. Because all of the links will be in there. So, I have a special link for their Etsy shop that takes you straight through to my discount code. Now, this discount code, this 20% off, is only valid until the 19th of December. So, it's a very time-limited offer, which is why it's so important that I record this vlog tonight.
Little tiny Swedish flower.
What does it mean? We're going to get to that.
I know.
She's too excited. She wants to do the whole vlog.
I know it.
Yes.
We're coming to it.
We're coming to it. Yes. So 20% discount with my code. So use my link in the description of this video or in my social media posts on Facebook and Instagram to do with this vlog. Can get there until the 19th of December. So it's a very time limited offer. You can buy as many calendars as you want. And they also have postcard bundles and... Whilst there are photos from the same shoots, they are sometimes different photos than the ones in the calendars as well. And I thought, because we're talking about Viking Age and all the times goddesses, I would explain where our names come from.
Yes.
Because that is relevant.
I think one of these flowers on Anne's t-shirt looks like a Linnea.
Yeah, I don't think it is one because Linnea is very rare. So Alice's name, Alice's full name is Alice Linnea
Gillespie.
Alice is a medieval name. So it's not quite Viking age, it's a medieval name. It comes from the German Adelheid, which means the noble one. And then it has been anglicised and francocised into Alice.
I'm going to call you Adelheid. No.
Adelheid.
What?
That's where your name comes from.
Yes.
My
name. And do you want to tell them what Linnea is?
It's a little Swedish flower. It's about like this big.
That's right. God, the cat's gonna cause an avalanche.
Oh my god, it's actually going to fall over.
Yes, Li- It's a tiny little bell-shaped flower that grows in the north of Sweden in the dark pine forest.
The flower is about, like, smaller than
the flower is tiny. Yeah, it's tiny. It was named after the Swedish botanist Carl von Linnaeus, and it was his favourite flower. I don't know what it was called before he came along and said, this is now a Linnea. I assume Omen. It would have had a name. Omen.
Omen, come Omen. In. Come in.
Okay, shh. But what I find so fascinating about this flower is not only is it beautiful, but it looks super delicate, but it's really, really tough. So I have seen one in real life once. Yeah. And this is when I went on a road trip through Sweden and Norway with my dad and my brother. And we went quite far north. So it's June, okay? And we're somewhere in northern Sweden. Not super duper duper northern Sweden. Sweden's very long. Yeah, we're somewhere in this deep wooded place. And we have just had a snowball fight because there are still deep drifts of snow around, even though it's June. And then after the snowball fight, we went for a walk and I saw this flower. So it's flowering while there's still snow around. So that's Alice's name. Shall we get on to Elin's name? Elin Iduna. Iduna is my friend who's the photographer of this calendar. That's where Elin's middle name comes from. Aww. And basically, I got to know Iduna after I'd moved to London. So even though she's a Gothenburg lass like myself, I didn't know her until after I left. And I got introduced to her and I went, oh my God, that's the coolest name I've ever heard. And she went, I know, right? But, you know, in Gothenburg accent and therefore a lot less camp. And I just loved the name so much. I thought it was beautiful. So yes, Elin got the name Iduna because Elin is my little Viking warrior, especially surviving the birth that she had. Yes. So you're Elin Iduna?
Yep, she could be.
And Elin is also a medieval name. It's from the same root as Helen, so it's from a Greek word meaning light. But we have, for example, a nun that was known as Saint Elin of Skövde. And Skövde is the town that my mom and grandmother and great-grandmother were all from. And my great-grandmother's name was Elin, so that's where that comes from. So we have two medieval names.
Yes.
And we have one Viking name, Biduna. And then Tuva is a Viking name too. It's a female version of Thor, the thunder god. Which I always say is what you get when your parents were Swedish hippies. You don't get Belladonna or Rainbow, you get a thunder god. Apparently I was very, very angry at being born. And my parents were in absolute agreement that my name was Tuva.
I want to talk about the lesbian one.
You have to wait a moment. And then my middle name, which I absolutely hate and detest, is Margareta. Basically Magrat. Sorry, Margaret. And I really don't like that, but that too is a medieval name. There's a lot of medieval queens called Margaret or Margareta. So that takes it up to three medieval names and two Viking names and then a little delicate but tough as flower, which sounds reasonable. What did you want to say about Gillespie, your surname?
Me and then surname and delicate surname.
Yes.
So Gillespie is a Scottish servant.
Surname, yeah, that's right. It's a Scottish surname.
Yeah.
Because that's where your dad's dad was from.
Yeah, my daddy.
So their great-grandfather on their dad's side was from Islay, an island in Scotland known for its whiskey. And there's a whiskey distillery there called Cowl Illa. They make very good whiskey. Islay whiskey is amazing. Anyway, on the label of the Cowl Illa whiskey is two rows of cottages, and their great-grandfather was born in one of those cottages. There's a claim to fame.
Wow.
My surname, Redmo, is one that my great-great-grandfather took. He got fed up with being called Svensson, which is basically the Swedish equivalent of Clark or Smith, and made up his own name. And that's me and my family. So that's a very new name, but it's still kind of cool. The discount code for the calendar is ParentXP. That will give you 20% off. So you can type it in their Etsy store, and that's a capital P, capital X, capital P, ParentXP. that will give you 20% discount on everything in their Etsy store. So calendar and postcard bundles. Or as I mentioned before, use the link that is in the description for this video or in my social media posts on Facebook and Instagram about this vlog that are related directly to this vlog. The discount code is only available until the 19th of December, but that will also give them a chance to send it out in time for Christmas. So yeah, hurry up. They send worldwide from their Etsy store as well. So it doesn't matter where in the world you are. And as I mentioned, the calendar's in English and it hasn't got any bank holidays or anything like that in it. So it'll work everywhere. We are all a bit too tired. Here's the photo of Ran. And I love it. I think it's amazing. It's taken underwater. She is dragging a drowned man in a fishnet with her. And that fishnet is hand knotted as well. So I mentioned that they've made everything for this calendar. And actually a little fact, something that absolutely wasn't planned but just turned out, is that more than half the people involved in this project are chronically ill with Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, EDS.
Wow.
Not planned at all, it just happened to be that way. It seems like I know a lot of people with EDS. Is there anything else I need to say? My delicate little flower. My goddess of eternal youth. And I'm thunder! Thunder? Field of thunder? Thunder?
Maybe
and my name is made up.
Maybe about Caitlin's name? Caitlin's names?
Caitlin's name is very ordinary.
My name appears on actual runestones. Multiple of them.
That's
yes,
interesting.
Yes, Tuva and variations of Tuva appears
that's
on runestones.
Her name is from the goddess of thunder.
Feel the thunder, thunder.
Hi, I think I'm funny.
Probably not spelt the way I spell it on my tattoo. I have spelt my name out in runes on my wrist, but that is my spelling, how I choose to represent it. The runestones I have seen are very often depicting my name with just three letters, because the younger Futhark was, everything was abbreviated and shortened down, or you sort of use the same rune for multiple letters to make it easier. Whereas this is the elder Futhark. And yeah, I've definitely seen it spelt differently, so my little tattoo is how I choose to do it.
Oh,
yeah. Because that is either a U or a V. So a lot of people will have that as the second letter. So they would have the rune for T and then the rune for U and then the rune for F and the rune for A. Tufa.
Tufa.
Tuva is another version of my name.
Ah.
Yeah.
Wow. Very cool.
Tuva.
Cool.
Not Tufa.
Tufa.
Tuva, Tuva, Tuve, Tura, Turun.
Oh my god, there's loads of ways to
Torvi.
Spell your name.
And you could do A-L-Y-S-S for Alice. A-L-Y-S-S, Alice. That's the Gaelic, the Irish Alice.
Mm.
Yeah. But we do not spell Eilin's name with an extra I. No E-I-L.
No E-I-L.
It's not Eileen, it's not Elaine, it's Eilin.
Eilin.
E-L-I-N.
It's or Alan. Very...
Or Alan.
No, me and they got Alligator Alan.
Oh my god, what did we end up with? We had this...
Trevor.
Did we record it?
Trevor.
No, we didn't.
We didn't record it. We had this weird... We were very tired another evening when we were sitting here, the four of us. And Caitlin was telling the story of her grandfather who was asking how... the little girl Caitlin was looking after was doing, and Caitlin went, "Who is that?" And the response was, "Alan." Hi, this is Alan.
Nice to meet you.
Yes. And Caitlin has a male alter ego called Kevin when she puts on a fake beard and prances around special needs play scheme.
Yeah.
Being silly.
I don't remember my name.
Yeah, we'll get to it. And then mine is Trevor. Because when I used to work in recruitment in London, I would call people on the phone and I would introduce myself. Oh, hi, it's Tova from blah, blah, blah. And I would always get, oh, hi, Trevor. And then you became Max.
Yeah, Max.
a name, and then they just all started looking at me.
Oh, that was it, yeah. That's why Max had nothing to do with Alice.
And Max.
Nice to meet you, Max.
Nice to meet you, everyone. My name's Max. Max is a boy's name.
Should we pull this together and turn off the lights and start calming down and winding down for the night?
Absolutely.
Thank you so much for watching. Please hit the subscribe button.
Oh, you know.
Please follow History Calendars on their Instagram and Facebook for more pictures, for more information about how they made this calendar. You've got all that information in there, in the description of the vlog and in my social media posts. So come and find me on Facebook or Instagram. Hit the subscribe button on the YouTube channel as well so you don't miss any of our videos. And thank you so much for watching. See you again very soon. Bye!